Greetings of the day. I'm Megha Gupta, an assistant professor from Babu Banarsidas University, and today I'll be taking a lecture on nature and schools of Hindu law. While talking about the nature of Hindu law, in the case of Yagna Purushadasi versus Vaishya, the Supreme Court elaborately considered the question as to who are Hindus. The Supreme Court observed that the word Hindu is derived from the word Sindhu. The Persians pronounced Sindhu as Hindu, and hence the people who lived in the vicinity of the Sindhu River, that is the Indus River, became to be known as Hindus. Today, the term has lost its territorial significance and is also not a designation of nationality. To whom the Hindu law applies? It applies on any person who is a Hindu, Jain, Sikh or Buddhist, any person who is born of Hindu parents, and any person who is not a Muslim, Christian, Parsi or Jew, or who is not governed by any other personal law. When we talk about the schools of Hindu law, they are considered to be the commentaries and digestives of Smritis. These schools have widened the scope of Hindu law and explicitly contributed to its development. There are two major sub-schools, that are Mitakshara and Dhyabhaga. Mitakshara school is further divided into various sub-schools. Now coming to the Mitakshara school, it is one of the most important schools of Hindu law, and it is run by the Smriti, which was written by Yajnavalkya. This whole school is applicable to the whole of India except in the regions of West Bengal and Assam. These regions are governed by the Dhyabhag school. However, different parts of the country practice the Mitakshara school a little differently because of the different customary rules. Mitakshara school is further subdivided into five sub-schools named Banaras Hindu Law School, Mithila Law School, Maharashtra Law School, Punjab Law School and Dravid or Madras Law School. The first sub-school is the Banaras Law School, which is governed by broadly the Mitakshara law and governs northern India including Odisha. Viramottaradaya is one of the major commentaries that this law school follows. The second sub-school is the Mithila Law School, which is majorly practiced in northern Bihar. The principles of this law school prevail in the north, and the major commentaries which it follows are Vivad Natkar and Vivad Chintamani Smriti. The third sub-school is the Maharashtra or Bombay Law School. The Maharashtra Law School has the authority to exercise its jurisdiction over the territorial parts including Gujarat and some other Marathi speaking areas including Maharashtra and Bombay. The main authorities of this school are Veer Mitrodaya. The next law school is the Madras Law School, also known as the Dravid Law School. It tends to govern the whole southern part of India. It also exercises its authorities under Mitakshara Law School. The main Smritis which govern it are the Smriti Chandrika and Vijayanti. And lastly, we have the Punjab Law School, which is predominantly established in eastern Punjab, and it has its own customs and traditions. It also follows Veer Mitrodaya and its established customs. Now the next major school is the Dhyabhag School. It prevails predominantly in Assam and West Bengal. It is considered to be a digest for the leading Smritis. Its primary focus was to deal with partition, inheritance and joint family. According to Kane, it was incorporated between 190 and 1130 AD. It was formulated with a view to eradicate all the absurd and artificial principles of inheritance. The immediate benefit of this new digest is that it tends to remove all the shortcomings and limitations of the previously established principles. The Dhyabhag school has various commentaries which it follows, such as Dayataka, Veer Mitrodaya and Dattak Chandrika. With this, we end the topic of nature and schools of Hindu law. Thank you for joining us.